Why is Negan bringing me candy? This is very cool.
Yeah, Negan is a co-owner in a candy store up in Rhinebeck, New York. Samuel Sweets.
Samuel Sweets. Yeah. Wait. Do you own this with?
With Paul.
Paul Rudd?
Yeah.
I've heard about this.
Yeah, yeah.
Wait, no way. Wait, how do you own a candy shop? That's the coolest thing.
I know. It's a crazy deal. Paul and I have known each other for a while. He lives up near me, near Rhinebeck. And
I love Rhinebeck.
We know the guy that started this store 25 years ago, a guy named Ira Guttner, and he passed away suddenly. And we didn't want the store to be anything else than what it was. And so we decided to step in and buy the candy store, and that was... 2.5 years ago now, and yeah,
that's pretty cool that you do that. But
it's cool. It's a fun deal. And
what a great town.
You know, Paul and I have literally nothing to do with it, other than eating the candy.
Yeah, I mean, how fun is that? I mean, you could just go in. You're like, dude, I own this candy shop.
Yeah, my kid loves it.
Right?
Paul's kids love it. Yeah, we have another Andy Ostroy also is one of the owners, and his kid loves it. So I mean, the kids think it's fantastic.
What's the name again of the store?
Samuel Sweets.
Samuel Sweets. Yeah. Is this right on Main Street?
Sure is.
Is there a cigar store?
There
the
is on the corner there.
No, I love
Rhinebeck. French bistro there. And
yeah, Beekman Arms.
Yeah, Beekman Arms.
I just go there all the time with my parents.
I just had dinner there the other night.
Oh, it's fantastic.
Beekman Arms is awesome. It's where Alexander Hamilton and Aaron Burr apparently had their first sit down kind of
duel
and a spat. Their first spat that led
over
to
dinner?
A duel. Yeah.
Over a
yeah,
was it
but
four
yeah, George Washington
meal.
Kinda hung out. My kid can tell you the whole history of Beekman Arms at 7. He's obsessed with it.
I know, I love that town so much. I shout out to everybody.
Yeah,
out
well
there.
You're from Village Socrates. Pizza. Village Pizza,
say hi to
of
Al
course.
For me.
Yeah,
that's
we go
my
there
man.
All the time.
Al started in Socrates. And
yeah,
that's where
you're from, yeah. Right across the river.
Please give Al a hug for me.
I will absolutely. I'll be there.
Jimmy, how you doing? Hey, babe.
I'll be back there tonight, but the big parade, the Christmas spectacular, is Saturday night. So
that's right.
I'm sure I'm driving a truck in it or something.
Do you drive in the parade?
Oh yeah.
What kind of truck do you have?
I have two trucks. I have a farm truck, a 74 Ford, little 3-on-the-tree deal, and then the parade truck, which is a newer F-150, and then the kids sit in the back and throw candy out.
Yeah, that's what yeah. I got the F-150.
What do you got a truck for?
Was that? Well...
I mean, we have trucks for specific reasons.
I got mine for when it's pumpkin season.
See? There's a reason.
Put a couple of pumpkins in the back and you gotta... I can't put them in a car.
That's awesome. No.
You
gotta have a big pumpkin
pumpkins.
What are you
gonna do ask me how big my truck is.
How big's your truck?
Big enough. That's what you say to people, yeah.
Big enough for
big
the
enough.
Great pumpkin,
big enough.
Charlie
I got
Brown.
The F-150, yeah.
I got the same truck.
Tonight Show Blue, I got.
Nice.
Custom color in Michigan, yeah. Absolutely, shout
good
out
for
to
you.
Detroit, yeah.
Ford, hey, Ford.
What a great truck.
Yeah, it's a great truck.
It's bigger than my first apartment.
Are you listening?
It's the best thing I ever purchased in my life. I love it.
I'm a little obsessed with my trucks. But,